Dude, I was so horny. Sorry about the background. I don't know why YouTubers apologize for background so much, and now I am. There also happens to be some music from the neighbors, but I'm in New York, so screw everything. Okay, I'm gonna talk about HRT, hormone replacement therapy. Why I do it, should you do it? Well, I'm not gonna say you should do it, you should see a doctor. This is just my personal experience with it. If you have terrible PMS, if you're thinking about HRT, speak to a doctor. I wanna warn you how strong this stuff is. So here we go. I had terrible PMS for years, 3 weeks of unexaggerated frustration, exhaustion. My breasts were so swollen, I couldn't even roll over in bed. They hurt so much. 8 pound weight gain, puffy face, sore back. I don't think you even want me to continue listing the symptoms. Onwards. I lost patience with this crap and I went on the progesterone and testosterone. Those are the things that I take for HRT. That's it. It's so strong. You need to be mindful of this. And I'm going to tell you the symptoms and what happened when I took just a little bit too much. And yes, testosterone is also in women, not just in men. And as we get older, it decreases, especially if you have an excess of training, dieting, stress. And I had all of that. Do not inject more than prescribed. I will say it has helped my periods and my overall energy tremendously. However, the first time I took testosterone, I administered too much for my body. I also believe I just subconsciously wanted too much because I was like so sick of being a woman. So here are the symptoms if you take too much. 1, I now understand why men are so horny. All I thought about was sex, but it was actually soothing and made me feel alive. It wasn't frustrating, at least for a woman. Way too much information. Weirdly, I sympathize with men because of this. I was like, wow, they just are hormonally driven to constantly think about sex. Yeah, enough about sex. The second one, my voice dropped. Testosterone can elongate and thicken your vocal cords if you take too much. So if you're a singer, be very careful. I noticed my voice cracking, much like a 14-year-old boy going through puberty. Thicker vocal cords produce a deeper, lower pitch. I used to have a very high-pitched voice, so this was a very big change. If you take too much for too long, your voice may not return. But when people say, oh, your voice will just go back to normal. No, it won't. Not entirely, at least. And I'm telling you this just from experience. 3, I leaned out. My body leaned out. It doesn't have the same effect right now because I don't take as much testosterone. Like, really, I don't take much at all. But it was definitely easier to be lean. Men have that part so easy. Women are soft and men are hard. I'm slightly bitter about that for sure. But at least our soft parts are hot as hell. Yeah, it's hot. When your testosterone levels fall below normal, your muscle mass declines, causing your metabolism to slow. The more muscle mass you have, the more calories you burn. Basic. 4, my breasts got smaller because it can shrink your breast tissue if you take too much. This was not cool. I don't want my breasts to shrink, but it did reverse that effect now that I'm on less. Side note about breasts, there must be a biological reason for their appeal. When I would write and I would get like nervous writing, I would always hold my breasts. Oh my gosh, why do I share this much? Okay, dialing it back now. 5, I was frustrated, but I tend to get frustrated just as a person, so I couldn't really tell if it was me or the testosterone, but the testosterone for sure increased it. And I saw it more frequently. Okay, next. 6, it was hard to cry on cue. I'm an actress, I have to do that. The reason men cry less than women is because they have higher testosterone levels, besides societal reasons, which inhibit crying. The reason women cry more is not because we're crazy, but we have more fluctuating hormones and more prolactin, which can promote tears. Of course, there are societal reasons for this. It's not as accepted for men to cry, which is sad. That's sad. You should go cry about it. You should figure out a way to cry about it. But in my personal experience, yes, the testosterone made it harder for me to cry. Usually I'm pretty good at that. If you were to watch my demo acting reel, it's just me being hired to like cry like a crazy person. The moment I realized this was when I was like, okay, I need to thoroughly decrease the testosterone because I can't let anything negative impact my acting. You know, I'm not that good. Also, crying is good for you. Yeah. In infants, tears serve as a communication tool, allowing them to show need for support. As an adult, it's cathartic. A biochemist noted that emotional tears carried more protein than non-emotional tears, like if you were to cry from an onion. So it brings a healing process. You also need to be careful because taking this, if prescribed, could increase cardiovascular problems. That's not good. Don't get a heart attack, okay? The other thing I do to help my PMS is take a progesterone pill, but only around my cycle. I do this because I naturally have estrogen dominance, which is only cool because it makes my breasts big. But it's exhausting, can make you so puffy and just effing sad. Taking progesterone, which we produce naturally, relieves the PMS symptoms. It promotes better sleep because it has a calming effect, which is why you would take it at night. It has a sedative and anti-anxiety effect, stimulating benzodiazepine receptors. I'm gonna write that down somewhere. It improves bone health, apparently reversing osteoporosis because it stimulates osteoblasts and prevents bone loss. It also helps fertility, which is the last thing that I want. Progesterone promotes survival of the embryo and fetus. It helps regulate the menstrual cycle. It lowers irritability, anxiety, mood swings, abdominal bloating, and breast tenderness. These are all PMS symptoms. I don't think that God or the creator made the female body to be so miserable. Yes, we have a huge responsibility if we decide to take it, to carry and nurture an actual human with our very own amazing bodies. But with modern times, high stress, technology, diet culture, processed food, pollution, insert 1,000 more reasons here, we have created this terrible PMS, which I think is a disease. I think it's an illness. I don't think we're supposed to have PMS. I don't think we're supposed to be so miserable every month. I will continue to try to find ways that are natural that will heal my symptoms. But in the meantime, I will do HRT because I need to be a functional, sane person. And that's it. Stay horny, guys.